Louis Armstrong, he's the greatest figure in American jazz. He just brought so much joy and happiness and love to people around the world. And as a musician, technically, he's on the highest possible level because there's no barrier between horn and his soul. So he just bypassed all of the technical limitations. He was such a master of the music. So when you hear Louis Armstrong playing the trumpet, it's not even a trumpet, it's just Louis Armstrong.
That we love today without Louis Armstrong. The way he played and sang made a permanent mark on American music. The generations of musicians who succeeded him owe him so much. Tonight we are here to celebrate his 90th year and to pay tribute. Too many people remember Armstrong from the later years. Too many people haven't done their homework and have no idea of what he meant to jazz, both at the time he played and today through the musicians who would not play as they do if it had not been for Louis Armstrong. Simply put, he was the greatest improviser in the history of the music. Before him, it was an ensemble form primarily, and he was a great ensemble player. But after him and his new solos, there was chorus after chorus of developed solos. He did things that people had never heard before. Choruses of 16 or 32 bars, the high note playing in jazz. A lot of the figures, the cliches and phrases that you hear musicians play today came directly from Louis Armstrong. He defined the music and gave it another direction. Michael White, who you will hear play tonight with Wenton, said that Armstrong was like magic. So it is fitting that we welcome back a young magician of today, Wynton Marsalis.
See, what you have to realize about Louis, Louis just happened to be the first real genius level performer to come out of the city of New Orleans.